Hello, welcome to this next episode in our series on 8-meter yachts and 8-meter racing, now in anticipation of the 8-meter World Cup in Turku in August in 2025. I'm now at a boatyard in Kotka called RedSky, and behind me here is one of the Finnish entries for the World Cup, the 8-meter yacht Ilderim, and I'm now here to learn how the yard is actually then preparing Ilderim and other 8-meter yachts then here in their care for the World Cup. So let's see what is being done to make sure that the boat is maximally competitive when it then starts into the first race in August.
Okay, so my name is Chris Winter, manager of RedSky Yachts, which is located in Kotka, Finland. What we do is we work on meter boats. A lot of what our business is restoration and new build of meter boats from half models right up to 12-meter size boats. We won the European Championship in the 6-meter class last year in a modern boat or an open class boat called Oiva, which was designed and built here in Kotka. And I do a lot of 12-meter sailing. I'm currently the president of the International 12-meter Association. So we look at meter boats and we try and make meter boats as fast as possible within the class rules.
Well, I'm Ville Savolainen. I'm designer here at RedSky Yachts.
Okay, so the 8-meter rule, like all the meter boat rules for the different classes, the 6-meter, the 8-meter, the 12-meter, they take into account basically the amount of water that the boat displaces and combine that with a sail area to come up with a rating for the boat. And that's what we're going to look at today, is how we look at the displacement of the boat through a scanning system and the measurement certificate, and how the sailmakers come up with a certain sail area to combine with that to have the boat fit within the 8-meter rule for the class or the division that they're sailing in. Problem is that as boats age, they change their shape a bit. As owners add or subtract parts to the boat, the weights of the boats change, so the displacement changes a little bit. And in order to have an accurate certificate, you need to have an accurate displacement of the boat. And that's what we're involved in, making sure that your boat is going to match your certificate so that it's legal as an 8-meter to go out and race against the other 8-meters. And the beauty of the rule is that there are lots of different ways to go about displacing water and adding or subtracting sail area and still get these boats to go out and race against each other and be fair. So Ilderim came in for preparation for the Worlds, which involves fairing the hull, sanding the hull, making everything on the boat in proper condition for the World Championship, but also documenting that the boat itself is what's represented on the certificate. And we're very comfortable that it is after we've done the scan and looked at the actual displacement and the measurement marks and such on the boat. So a scan, with a scan, you can actually take a realistic three-dimensional picture of the boat. And with Ville skills, using that scan, using the point cloud and the boat represented in a digital form, you can tell exactly how much water the boat's going to displace, which is basically the most accurate measurement of the boat you can take. And then you looked at the measurement marks are properly placed on the boat, and with that correctly done, the boat can go out and get measured when it's in the water, and it will be exactly the same as it is on the certificate and in real life documented through the scanning process.
Well, we have laser scanned the boats with the hand scanner, like 3D scanner, and then the software makes a mesh out of the point cloud, and then we take the mesh and make a surface from the mesh, and then we can use the surface to align the surface with the flotation marks that we have been measured before the scan and when the boat was on the water.
Okay. So
we align the boat with the correct water line, and then we can start working with that. Yeah, so this is the mesh, scanned mesh from the Ilderim, and it looks like this. So lots of small triangles together.
And engineers want to know, so what's the kind of the precision? Is it like centimeter class or
no? This is like 0.05 millimeter, so it's very accurate.
Okay.
There is like maybe we are within 1 millimeter with this, the whole boat. So this is surprisingly accurate.
So the things that you can modify to some degree are going to be the displacement, which is the weight of the boat. There is a minimum displacement. There are other factors, but when you're within the range, you can make an adjustment in the weight. You can make an adjustment as to where the weight is so that the boat floats higher a little bit in the front or floats a little bit higher in the back. And as you change that, then you can look at sail area. So if you want to increase sail area in a meter boat, in general, you have to reduce the displacement. So you make the boat shorter on the waterline and you can increase the sail area. You make the boat longer on the waterline, you have to decrease the sail area. To some degree, in the 12 meter class, when they are racing in the America's Cup, they look at the conditions that they're going to race under, and they may try to optimize the boat for those particular conditions. But our experience working in the meter boats is that you want to have a boat that's consistently fast, maybe not the fastest in every condition, but consistently fast so that you can operate over a wide range of conditions. No, I think in this case, it was merely confirmation that the measurement certificate and the boat were going to represent the same thing,
right?
That it's an accurate measurement and we can carry on. They can get new sails, they can do everything based on the fact that the measurements are accurate on the boat. Then you look at the boat and you go, okay, the boat itself is going to fit within the rule now. So what can we do? Well, we can work on the bottom of the boat. The bottom of the boat's going through the water, so the smoother it is, the better it's going to be. And it's interesting, in the point cloud, in the scan that you get, you can actually see the imperfections in the bottom of the boat. You still displace basically the same amount of water, but you can make slight filling in certain areas. And you can make sure that the paint is fair. You can wet sand the boat. You can sand the boat to a fairly high degree to make sure it slides through the water well.
Okay.
So everybody likes their boat to look nice. We like it to look nice, but we like it to function well as well. Working on your blocks, working on the components of the boat that the crew uses, working on the ropes, working on the winch systems to make sure everything is as easy as possible so that the boat can be tacked quickly, and you won't have any problems on the race course. Like, you can do everything right, you can have a perfect boat, but if you break down on the race course, it's a failure. So our job is also to make sure that nothing is going to fail during the race. The idea is that all the boats go the same speed, so the best team wins. And to be the best team, you prepare your boat properly, you go out and practice and obey the rules and sail hard, play fair.